Pope Francis has made many decisions these past few years that have surprised us, shaken us out of our patterns of thinking and being. His actions, gestures, and writings make us think in new ways. They bring us to prayer. They challenge us greatly and touch us deeply. The decision of his to make me a bishop has done all these things. They've done these things to me in a very personal way, very real way. So, as a humbled recipient of this office of bishop, I thank Pope Francis and I pledge my unwavering loyalty. I wish also to thank Cardinal Sean O'Malley for all he has done, bring some healing to our archdiocese, and for his trust in me. There are so many I could mention, but I can do that individually as I have not arrived at this podium unaided. I have got to this place helped, protected, prayed for, and loved by so many bishops, priests, religious men and women, and lay people. They are the only reason I'm here. I will spend just a moment to mention my deceased father. Somewhere in heaven, he is rubbing his hands together with delight. I am so grateful to God that my mother, yes, that's Bethany Healthcare Center in Framingham, I'm so happy that she can share this joy, as well as my two brothers and my sister and my nieces and nephews and extended family. I have no idea what is beyond August 24th for me, but I give thanks for the part of my life that is ending. I love the priesthood, and I would have been quite happy to serve in this capacity for the rest of my life. But I have never said no to the church, and I'm not going to stop now. I am so grateful to God that my mother at Bethany can help. I wish to speak just a moment about my motto I have chosen, which is In Venimus Messiam. Anybody got it? I chose this motto as I'm a devoted to St. Andrew. These are his words when he spoke to his brother, who became Peter. When he met Jesus, he went immediately to his brother and said, "We have found the Messiah." In Latin, "In Venimus Messiam." In John's Gospel, Andrew is an evangelizer. When he meets Jesus, he goes immediately to his brother, and then later, when there is not enough for the crowds, he brings a child to Jesus with 2 fish and 5 loaves. Later in John's Gospel, he meets the Gentiles, the Greeks, and he and Philip bring them to Jesus. So Saint Andrew in John's Gospel first brings his family, then brings a child, then brings the outsiders all to the Lord. Please God, I will bring people to meet the Messiah, Jesus Christ, who is my Lord and to whom I owe everything in my life, and now to whom I serve in a different way as bishop. Thank you.